Our experts believe, and the data shows, that most of the price increases we've seen were expected and are expected to be temporary. There's nobody suggesting there's unchecked inflation on the way. No serious economist.
Let's check that no unchecked inflation claim. Now, if you have a car, it costs you twice as much to run it as it did last year. Fuel prices have doubled. Your daily breakfast now comes with an 8% price hike, as the cost of milk, bacon, and fruit have gone up. On top of that, you've got consumer prices that have hit their highest amount since 2008. Now, despite the president's assurances, America's working families, already being hard hit by the pandemic, are starting to feel the pinch.
The groceries are definitely up, and also the rents are also going up, and just household items.
We're making serious progress to ensure that it works the way it's supposed to work, for the good of the American people.
Well, construction material is out of this world. Somebody's making some good money, and I think it's because of Joe Biden.
We could help families and small businesses weather the ups and downs of as the economy recovers.
I don't buy anything, honestly, what the government even says nowadays. I truly, truly don't.
Look, we brought this economy back from the brink.
Now, Biden refuses to hear those voices. Perhaps he'll listen to those within his own party.
Labor market tightness, behavior of housing markets, and asset prices all rising in a more concerning way than I worried a few months ago. This raises my degree of concern over heating scenario. There are huge uncertainties, but the focus of concern now should be on overheating.
And if that's not enough to change the president's mind on the economy, perhaps this comparison is the wake-up call he needs.
The U.S. is in a very bad position from a long-term point of view. I don't see how these can end well when we are running now budget deficits something like 15% of GDP. This is beginning to look a little bit like a Latin American country.
Printing and spending money like there's no tomorrow has pretty clearly got people concerned.
Biden gave the excuse that the spending is necessary to tamp down inflation, which is ridiculous. That has nothing in common. You can't stop the consequences of monetary printing by doing even more monetary printing, which is what it means to spend this level of money. And the fact is that Biden and all of his advisors and the political party that he represents are big spenders, and they want to spend more money. They think that the U.S. government can go into infinite amounts of debt, that there's no limits whatsoever. They really believe this.
Biden assures us the problems are just temporary, but perhaps it's a bit like the pandemic and the economic aftermath. It's a bigger problem than was first thought, but it seems to be a problem that Biden's apparently incapable of recognizing. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.